So hello, we're now going to have a look at managing our software repositories or installation sources on SUSE Linux Enterprise 11. The main tool we're going to look is the Zypper command, so we're going to run that from the command line. Zypper was first introduced in SUSE Linux Enterprise Server 10, Service Pack 1. So here, if we run the sudo zypper command, so zypper needs supervisory privileges to run. If we run sl, it's going to list my installation sources. So we have one at the moment, and its name is repository. So this is just my installation sources. For the moment, we'll take this installation source out and then add a new one in. So I'm changing the zypper command now to add repository, or sorry, I'll do a remove repository first. Remove repository, the repository name, which is repository. We can see that in both the alias and the name in the output above. So of course now do a service list, so we don't have any repositories. And then we can search for software. Of course, without any repositories, we can't find software to install. So let's now go through and add that repository. So AR for add repository. We're going to put a network installation source. So this could be HTTP, SMB, NFS, FTP. So there's the address, and we give the repository a name. So I'll call it network. Of course, need to run it with the sudo command. Just a good demonstration that we need to be running this with root privileges. If you believe that, you'll believe anything. So now, of course, if I go through and list my installation sources, so SL, we see now that I have an installation called network with an alias of network. I can set the alias to be something different from the name if I want. So if I search for software now, so SE for search, I can search for the whois package, and we can now see that it's found both the source and the package from the installation repository network. And then if I wanted to, I could install the software with IN. And just yes to accept. So these can be quite easy to maintain from the command line. You can build these into installation scripts as well, or into management scripts on your machine later on. What we're going to do now is then just go and remove the package that we just put on. So we're going to remove the whois package. So uninstall the software whois. And then remove the repository. Network. So that's it. We're back now with no software repository. So of course, do the SL. Nothing there. So move away from the command now and just look at something similar. So if you don't like the command line or just want to get used to using the GUI first in Linux, which is fair enough, we can do the same type of thing through the graphical tool YaST. If I move down to software. Software repositories. So really this is my service list, and we can see that there's nothing there. So we then choose add, put in an HTTP selection, put in the repository name. This is just building up, if you like, our command line argument. So I'll call it install this time. And then put in my server, so 172.17.0.100 or whatever, put a DNS name in. I could skip the port number because it's the default port number. and I'm going to the directory SUSE. So I'm creating installation source called install that's pointing to the same HTTP server that was pointing to before. So there we have it, using the Zypper and YaST utility to create and manage your software repositories. Hopefully you find it useful. And remember, this is equally applicable to SUSE Linux Enterprise and openSUSE 11 and above. Remembering this first came in Enterprise 10 Service Pack 1. Thank you.